Flow cytometry isn't just another lab technique. It's a vital tool that can save lives. If you're in diagnostics or research, mastering this unique skill can set you apart in your field. Your goal? To analyze thousands of cells in seconds, uncovering crucial information about a patient's health that could change their treatment. But here's the problem. Without a solid understanding of flow cytometry, the data can feel overwhelming, leading to missed insights that could be critical for patient care. The good news? In this video, we'll break down flow cytometry, simplifying this complex topic and showing you why it's so important. Whether you're just starting or looking to enhance your expertise, stick with us. In this video, we will dive into the world of flow cytometry. Here's what we'll cover. 1. Introduction to flow cytometry. We'll start by understanding what flow cytometry is and why it's so important in medical labs. 2. How flow cytometry works. Next, we'll explore the mechanics behind this powerful technique. This is the most crucial part of our discussion. 3. Applications of flow cytometry. Then, we'll look at how flow cytometry is used in various fields, highlighting its importance in diagnostics and research. 4. Advantages of flow cytometry. We'll also discuss the benefits of using flow cytometry compared to traditional methods. 5. Challenges and limitations. Finally, we'll wrap up with some challenges and limitations associated with this technique. But before we dive in, I want you to pay attention to two important points. First, you can change the video captions into Hindi, Urdu, Tamil, Bengali, and more. Just check the settings or search YouTube for how to change captions. Second, at the end of this video, I'll challenge you with a question that could give you an edge in your competitive exams. It's your chance to grab that crucial one mark. So stay alert and engaged. Let's start the topic. Introduction to flow cytometry. So, what exactly is flow cytometry? In simple terms, it's a lab technique that lets us examine cells individually. Instead of looking at a sample as a whole, flow cytometry isolates each cell, measuring its unique characteristics like size, structure, and specific markers. This technique is like having a microscope, laser, and computer all rolled into one, allowing us to gather precise data on each cell that passes through the instrument. It's an essential tool in modern labs, especially in diagnosing complex diseases. How flow cytometry works. 1. Sample preparation. It all begins with sample preparation. Cells in the sample are stained with fluorescent dyes or tagged with antibodies that target specific cell markers. When these cells pass through a laser beam, the dyes cause certain cells to emit light, helping to distinguish them from others. 2. Flow chamber. Next, the sample flows into a narrow chamber where cells are aligned single file and directed toward the laser. By moving one by one, each cell is examined individually, creating a clear, detailed profile. 3. Detection. As each cell crosses the laser, the light scatters in various directions depending on the cell's characteristics. Detectors capture these scattered light patterns, revealing details like the cell's size and internal structures. 4. Data analysis. Finally, this data is processed by specialized software, which translates it into readable information, generating precise counts, patterns, and details that scientists can interpret. The result? We get incredibly detailed insights into each cell in a sample, making it easier to identify abnormalities, count cell types, and analyze cell behaviors faster and more accurately than ever before. Applications of flow cytometry. Flow cytometry isn't just another lab tool. It's essential in fields that rely on precision. Let's explore a few of its key applications. Medical diagnostics. In diagnostics, it's used to track immune cells in conditions like HIV and leukemia. By providing an exact count of T cells, B cells, or other immune cells, flow cytometry helps doctors monitor patients' immune status and adjust treatments. Cancer research. In cancer research, flow cytometry plays a critical role in identifying tumor cells. Specific cell markers can reveal cancerous cells, which is especially important in personalized medicine, immunology, and stem cell research. In immunology, scientists analyze immune cell responses, helping in vaccine research and autoimmune disease studies. Flow cytometry also identifies stem cells and tracks their differentiation, aiding research into regenerative medicine. Advantages of flow cytometry. Flow cytometry offers three main advantages that make it invaluable in modern labs. Speed. It can analyze thousands of cells in just seconds, making it incredibly fast and ideal for high-throughput labs. Precision. With flow cytometry, we get cell-by-cell data, allowing detailed study of each cell's characteristics in complex samples. Versatility. Flow cytometry can measure multiple characteristics of cells simultaneously, such as size, internal complexity, and protein markers, making it adaptable to diverse research and clinical needs. Challenges and limitations. Of course, like any technology, flow cytometry has its challenges. Cost. Flow cytometers are expensive to purchase and maintain, and not all labs have the resources for it. Expertise. It requires skilled technicians to operate and interpret data, meaning extensive training is essential. Sample preparation. The process of staining and preparing samples is time-intensive and requires precision to avoid errors. Future of flow cytometry. The future of flow cytometry is bright, with innovations that promise to make it even more accessible and effective. New advancements like AI integration are automating data analysis, making interpretation faster and more accurate. Now it's time for the question. Here it is. In flow cytometry, which of the following characteristics of a cell is not typically measured during the analysis process? A. Cell size. B. Granularity. C. DNA sequence. D. Surface markers. Think carefully about your answer, as it relates to the key principles of how flow cytometry works. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like and subscribe for more on medical lab technology and innovations.